Hey guys and girls, Hugh Coscoyle here. In this quick video, we're gonna go over how temperature affects bass and how active they are and how they feed. So if you didn't know, bass are cold-blooded. They're not like us. We can wake up in the morning in the wintertime and be full of energy, go for a marathon run. Bass are not like that. They're cold-blooded. If it's warm outside, they're gonna be moving around. If it's cold, they're gonna tuck away, not be moving very much. They're directly influenced by the air temperature and the water temperature. Knowing this is gonna greatly affect my lure selection, what I'm using on any given day, different times of the year. So let's start out in colder weather at the beginning of the year. Bass and baitfish are a lot more sluggish. They need to conserve their energy. Their metabolism isn't very fast. They're not gonna be eating all the time throughout the day. So this is gonna influence my bait choice because a bass isn't gonna want to move nearly as far to go get something. It's not gonna chase something like it would in maybe the warmer months. So there's two things that I'm gonna do. First thing is I'm gonna start to throw more natural baits, a little bit more slow, a little bit more subtle of baits. This could be trick worms with not a lot of action, Senkos, or very slow moving baits like a Carolina rig or a shaky head. Getting those baits right in front of them, they have no choice but to swim over and look at it. That bait isn't moving very fast. It's an easy target for them to bite in the wintertime. Now, that doesn't mean that I don't throw reaction style baits in the wintertime. I want to throw reaction baits because I don't want to give those fish a chance to think about it. I can cover a lot more water, figure out where they are a lot quicker, but the colder weather is going to influence my bait selection. A lot of time when I start to cover water, I'm going to choose a bait that has a little bit less action, a little bit tighter wobble. So a lot of the crankbaits we have, square bills, are going to have a really wide wobble. That's not what I want in the wintertime. I want something that has a very, very tight wobble, something like a rattle trap. That's very, very natural. It mimics the bait fish really well because they're cold as well. They're not gonna be moving as much. They're not gonna be covering a lot of water, displacing a lot of water. That's gonna be really natural for the fish and that's gonna be really natural for the bass. So I'm gonna cover water with a rattle trap or maybe a chatterbait if I could, if it's not too cold, to cover water and see if I could find them. And then once I find them, I'm able to slow down with a worm or a jig, something a lot slower. It's a lot easier for those fish to eat. As the water temperature increases, their metabolism is going to increase. They're going to be a lot more willing to chase after a bait. You can see this all the time by going to a pond or going to a lake. You don't really see fish schooling, busting up out of the top of the water in the wintertime. You only really see that in the warmer months, spring through maybe the fall. That's telling me that the fish are a lot more active. They're willing to bite. They need to be eating a lot more in the summertime. When the wintertime, they might be only feeding once, maybe twice a day. They could be feeding all day during the summertime. So this time of the year, unlike the wintertime, I'm able to throw those wide wobbling crankbaits. That's gonna be a lot more natural this time of year. It's gonna get their attention. They're gonna investigate it and they're gonna eat it. I'm also able to throw bigger things like a big jig and a big worm. Something that might not get a bite in the wintertime, they're going to need more food in the summertime. They're willing to bite bigger baits in the summertime. The warmer months is also when we're able to throw topwater baits. In the wintertime, I would never even dream of throwing a topwater. It's way too cold for them to bust up out of the top of the water to eat something. So the warmer months from the spring into the fall is when I'm going to be able to throw frogs, spooks, poppers. Any other topwater baits is when I'm going to be in the warmer month. So guys, next time you get on the water, make sure you take in water temperature when you're choosing a lure. I want to choose things that are much more natural for that time of the year. It's going to lead to a lot more bites.